Good morning and welcome to our first day of distance learning. There will be no chapel, so we're going to start with our Bible verse, which we highlighted last week, John 10:9. So if you need to pause the video while you find it, do that. John 10:9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. John 10:9. John 10:9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. John 10:9. John 10:9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. John 10:9. John 10:9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. John 10:9. John 10:9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. John 10:9. All right, now turn in your Bible truths. We are doing 74 to 79. Can you repent and believe in Christ on your own? No, I cannot repent and believe in Christ without the help of God's Holy Spirit. Can children repent and trust Christ for salvation? Yes, He welcomes them to come to Him. How long has it been since Christ died? Christ died nearly 2,000 years ago. How were people saved before Christ came? People were saved by trusting in the Savior to come. What in the Old Testament pointed forward to the Savior's sacrifice for sin? Animals sacrificed on God's altar pointed to the Savior's sacrifice. Okay, let's do it again. Can you repent and believe in Christ on your own? No, I cannot repent and believe in Christ without the help of God's Holy Spirit. Can children repent and trust Christ for salvation? Yes, He welcomes them to come to Him. How long has it been since Christ died? Christ died nearly 2,000 years ago. How were people saved before Christ came? People were saved by trusting in the Savior to come. What in the Old Testament pointed forward to the Savior's sacrifice for sin? Animals sacrificed on God's altar pointed to the Savior's sacrifice. Can you repent and believe in Christ on your own? No, I cannot repent and believe in Christ without the help of God's Holy Spirit. Can children repent and trust Christ for salvation? Yes, He welcomes them to come to Him. How long has it been since Christ died? Christ died nearly 2,000 years ago. How were people saved before Christ came? People were saved by trusting in the Savior to come. What in the Old Testament pointed forward to the Savior's sacrifice for sin? Animals sacrificed on God's altar pointed to the Savior's sacrifice. Can you repent and believe in Christ on your own? No, I cannot repent and believe in Christ without the help of God's Holy Spirit. Can children repent and trust Christ for salvation? Yes, He welcomes them to come to Him. How long has it been since Christ died? Christ died nearly 2,000 years ago. How were people saved before Christ came? People were saved by trusting in the Savior to come. What in the Old Testament pointed forward to the Savior's sacrifice for sin? Animals sacrificed on God's altar pointed to the Savior's sacrifice. One more time. Can you repent and believe in Christ on your own? No, I cannot repent and believe in Christ without the help of God's Holy Spirit. Can children repent and trust Christ for salvation? Yes, He welcomes them to come to Him. How long has it been since Christ died? Christ died nearly 2,000 years ago. How were people saved before Christ came? People were saved by trusting in the Savior to come. What in the Old Testament pointed forward to the Savior's sacrifice for sin? Animals sacrificed on God's altar pointed to the Savior's sacrifice. All right, our story today, since we're not having chapel, I just found a little object lesson that I'd like to share with you. It comes from an old African folk tale, and it is just a fanciful story explaining why the thumb stands alone. But I hope you will learn a lesson from it. In Daniel, they tell the story about how Daniel stood up for what was right and did not follow what they were asking him to do because he did not feel it was right to do it. And so this story talks about standing up for what's right. It seems that one day the five fingers were lying on a table together when they noticed a fine gold ring across the table. "Hey," one of the fingers said, "let's take it." "Yeah," said the ring finger, "that sure would look good on me." They started to reach for the ring when the thumb protested. "Wait a minute, you can't do that," the thumb said. "Why not?" the fingers shouted almost in unison. "Because it would be wrong." "Oh, come on," one of the fingers said. "No one will see us." "It would be stealing," insisted the thumb. "You're nothing but a goody-goody," said the index finger. "Yeah, you're a party pooper," added the pinky. "Yeah, if you're going to be that way," added another finger, "you can't be a part of our group." "Right," said the other fingers. "Go away. We don't need you anymore." So the four fingers went off on their own little group and left the thumb standing alone. They thought he would give in and join them in what they wanted to do. But to this day, the thumb has stood alone and refused to do what was wrong. That's what God wants us to do when others try to get us to do something wrong. It may not be easy to stand alone, but it's better to resist our friends than to disappoint God. All right, so that's just a little lesson about standing up for what is right and doing the right thing, even when others are encouraging you to do the wrong thing. All right, see you for the next class.